I have another product review for you today, but this time it's a little different. It's pine pollen from the Canadian Pine Pollen Co. If you're interested, keep watching. So what makes this review a little bit different is why the Canadian Pine Pollen Co. did send me samples for testing and review. So it goes back to a video that I made a little while ago, which was all about harvesting, processing, using, and storing pine pollen. And of course, I'm going to put a link to that video at the end of this one and in the video description underneath. Now, it's quite a lengthy video, but it may well be worth your taking a look at. And the reason being is I'm not going to go into an extensive review of all the benefits of pine pollen. I'll assume either that you already are aware of those benefits, or if you are interested, you can go back to that video. I just want to keep this one a little bit short. Well, apparently, after I released that video, the people at the Canadian Pine Pollen Co. came across it, watched it, were impressed enough with the content that I had shared that they contacted me and said, we would like to send you a few samples of our products. Okay, so here's what's interesting. I had been aware of the Canadian Pine Pollen Co. before they reached out to me because I had found their website and gone through their tremendous amount of information they had when I was doing research for that first video. So I readily accepted their offer for a couple of reasons. I believe that they have great products, and they're a Canadian company, and that's what really did intrigue me. So this is a Canadian company that is located in British Columbia, Canada, and that's also where they do all of their harvesting of pine. So they go into the mountainous areas in the northern parts of British Columbia, and they harvest pine pollen from the lodgepole pine and the ponderosa pine up there. And they have a method that they have developed that is both ethical and sustainable. And this is what makes it a little bit different from a lot of other products that are out there in the market. Two things, I guess. One, it is local. It does not come from an offshore source where most of the pine pollen that you're able to purchase does come from. And you can rest assured that it is ethically sourced at the same time. So they have two products. Well, they have two types of products, we'll say. They do, as I mentioned, harvest from the lodgepole pine and the ponderosa pine, but they then turn that pine pollen into two products, one of which is a tincture form. So it is an alcohol-based tincture with the pine pollen inside. And the other one is pure raw pine pollen in a powdery form. And I'll give you a close-up of the powdery form in a second. But the powdered form is a little bit unique, again, from a lot of what the other products that you can purchase out there, in that it is in its raw state, meaning it has not been processed and processed in any way. That's important because once the pine pollen is processed, it starts a shelf life degradation. That means over a period of time, you won't get all the benefits from it. And as they will show in their research and literature on their website, they believe that the raw pine pollen has much greater metabolic benefits and nutritional benefits than any of the processed pine pollens have. So what can I say about these, having had them in my possession for some time now? Well, they come in two flavors, we'll say. That's the way that they explain it on their website. They say there's a bit of a difference between the ponderosa pine and the lodgepole pine. I'll be honest, I can't tell what the difference is. I guess my taste palate is not all that sensitive to those differences, but I can say that I enjoy using both. I use the powdered versions or the raw versions mostly in shakes, some morning shakes with some other ingredients so that I can drink it down as a bit of a tonic. I have used it in coffee, which is kind of an interesting because I didn't consider doing that before, but when I make my bulletproof coffee on occasion, I'll add in some pine pollen. It does stay well mixed in the mixture and adds a little bit of flavor. It certainly doesn't add any objectionable texture, and that's another way of getting the pine pollen in if you want to do it that way. It's certainly not harmed at all by the heat or the coffee or being suspended in the liquid. The tincture, of course, you place under your tongue by number of drops, and there's recommended dosages written on the bottle. has a pleasant flavor. I note that some people find that the alcohol burns a little bit. It's not a high percentage alcohol, but you can feel it stinging a little bit under your tongue, but it's not objectionable in any way. And in fact, I enjoy the flavor of it quite a bit. So yeah, it's a good quality product. What can I say about having taken it for some time now? I said in the other video that you will notice a difference in your health, your metabolism, your energy levels, and that's true. And I do with this as well. I have found that I'm not taking it every day, but on days that I know I'm going to be very active, like go to the gym, go out to the woods, or any other physical labor, that taking this seems to give me an extended period of energy during the day. Or taking it after a workout or after having been in the woods seems to rejuvenate me some. Now, I'm not going to say it's a miracle drug and it's answer to all your ills. I don't think there is any such thing, but I can say that it does seem to provide me a degree of benefit that I can appreciate the value in taking it. Okay, what I want to do is I'll just give you a quick look at the powder in my hand, and then I have one more comment I want to make before we wrap up. Okay, just quickly, I wanted to share what the pine pollen from the Canadian Pine Pollen Company does look like. So this is the ponderosa pine that I have opened and started using. So I'll just put a little bit into the cap so you can see its powdery nature. And hopefully that's showing up well enough on camera there. And as I mentioned, it dissolves very readily in any hot drink that you want to use it for, or in a shake in itself. You could put it directly in water. It works well there as well. It does have a bit of a powdery texture to it. It certainly does not have any objectionable flavors. In fact, there is a bit of an enjoyable flavor to it. Maybe not quite so much as the tincture, but it's still very palatable at that. Okay, I have one more comment I want to make, and then we'll wrap this video up. Okay, I did intend for this to be just a short video, kind of putting out there that there is a Canadian source for pine pollen harvest in the most sustainable and ethical manner possible. And you may want to, especially if you're from Canada and you're interested in getting some pine pollen, definitely take a look at their website. Not only that, they have a YouTube channel, which I will link, of course, as well. And in that YouTube channel, you'll meet the owners of the company, and they will go over a number of questions and answers about pine pollen in general, as well as demonstrating its harvesting and that type of thing. They have one other product that they sent to me. I was not expecting this. I was not even aware that they made it, and that is soap. So apparently they started making soap with some of the residue from the processing that they, or you know, the harvesting of the pine pollen. And if you watch my video, that you'll notice that the pine pollen does come in a pollen cone, which looks like a number of little yellowish greenish berries on a little branch type of a thing. There's usually some type of a powdered leftovers. I call it a bran. I don't know what else to refer to as. Well, they've discovered that they can incorporate that into soaps with a variety of smells or flavors or whatever you want to call it. And they have those soaps for sale. So they put one in with the package. Now, I'm not a bar soap person. Personal admission here, I don't use a lot of bar soap. I use a liquid soap most of the time. But I wanted to try this, of course, and I think I'm a bit of a convert. I like the smell. I like the way that the texture is with the materials inside of the soap. And, well, to a point that I'm actually probably going to order some after this to replace it. The bar is lasting a good long time. I like how it makes me feel. And so I know this was not meant to be a soap commercial, but they do have soap available that if you're going to order some of the pine pollen, take a look at the bars of soap. Maybe you'll want to add one of those to your order as well. So as I mentioned, I will be putting the information where you can purchase the pine pollen from the Canadian Pine Pollen Company, as well as links to their YouTube channel. And as I mentioned, a link to my original video where you can get much more information about the value of consuming pine pollen. All right, that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions, then please put those in the comments section below, or any comments, of course. But until next time, get out and explore and take that path less traveled, because it will make all the difference. Bye for now.